the blue crab. One look at its claws, and you can see how it got its name. These colorful crustaceans are among the harbor's most famous residents. Let's take a closer look at these fascinating creatures. Blue crabs live underwater, and they spend most of their time here on the bottom. They prefer soft surfaces they can potentially burrow into, like sand or mud. They also like to sit in underwater grasses. The blue crab has 5 sets of limbs, the most obvious of which is their powerful front claws. But they also have 3 sets of walking legs. When they use them, they move not forward or backward, but side to side. Here, we can also see its last set of limbs, its swimming legs. The ends of these limbs are flat, so the crab can use them like a paddle. It can use these paddles to swim. Up close, we can see that the blue crab has a pair of eyes and a pair of antennae. But in between them, there's a second pair of antennae that is perhaps most fascinating. These tiny appendages, also known as antennules, play a key role in how the crab is able to smell. The antennules have extremely small chemosensory hairs on their ends. And as they move back and forth, they can capture odors in the water. When they pick up a trace of an interesting chemical, the antennules can actually reach backward into a hole in the shell where their olfactory organ is located. Here, at the harbor's edge, we can see a crab doing just that. This is that same crab filmed underwater, and you can see it waving its 3rd maxilla pin. The 3rd maxilla pins cover the crab's mouth and appear to be part of the crab's shell, but they are actually highly flexible. Directly behind them are the smaller 1st and 2nd maxilla pins. The crab can move these very quickly, as you can see here. These tiny appendages help them redirect the flow of water into their gills. They can beat them up to 16 times a second. One of the many talents of the blue crab.